Hello everyone and welcome back to Guardians of the Galaxy. In the last session, we've been making our way across this planet towards the home of Lady Hellbender.
That is not a happy monster.
Well, at least it left.
Back to its broodmother, Lady Hellbender.
Ugh. Yeah, I doubt it, Drax. Come on. Why is the bridge always on the wrong side?
This time I insist we hurl the foul beast.
I insist we push muscles over the side of the cliff.
To what end?
Yours!
Encourage Drax or stop
you
Drax again.
Dead!
It's interesting that this is a choice that doesn't have a timer. It was the same with the last one of this choice, which makes me think it's actually important. But I will stop him again.
You are!
How many times do I have to say it? We're not throwing rockets.
Ridiculous. You were holding us back to spare the beast's feelings. When has he done the same for us?
Put him down.
Let's be a lesson to you.
Oh, I'll show you what a lesson looks like.
Knock it off, guys. We're supposed to be professionals. We're better than this.
I'm not.
Letting a grisly Chitauri installation stop our progress is unprofessional.
Then stop wasting time arguing. We'll find another way across.
Okay, cool. I can't actually see the building. Is it over there, roughly? The building that we're trying to get to?
I sure hope that buttless beast ain't running back to mommy to tell on us.
If we can't get across it, maybe we can go around it.
Looking for cracks, caves, or crevices, people.
I feel like I've heard you say that before, but in a different context.
Guys, I've got something here. It's deep. This looks promising.
There's little room to maneuver if something should attack.
There it is. There's the building.
We're not gonna be here long.
Anybody see a way through?
We'll make one if we have to.
Oh, anybody else smell that? It really stinks back here.
Yes, it smells putrid.
Drax can hurl heavy objects at a structure's scanned weakness.
Definitely something gross behind here.
In many ways, this planet reminds me of my home world.
That bad, huh?
Katath is not a place for the weak. The punishing weather and lethal predators force every Katathian to fight for survival.
That's why you respect Lady Hellbender so much. She survived a place like this.
And conquered it.
Nice. Alrighty then, Drax.
Can you chuck that through the stink wall?
I fear I will regret this. That is disturbingly fragrant.
Disturbingly fragrant. Looks like this is a fight arena.
Every orifice right now.
Something that I was forgetting last time is that there's a lock-on in this game. And I was struggling to hit the spiky boys inside the jellies.
Anybody?
And that was because I just forgot that there was a lock-on ability. So I'm going to remember that now and hopefully... hopefully won't have any more issues aiming.
Blood pumping.
Just completely slipped my mind.
Why would Lady Hellbender cage this creature?
Because it's annoying as scud.
Perhaps it is food.
That thing's food?
Yes, monster food.
I wonder what it tastes like.
Peter.
Why would it taste like that?
We can use this.
You know, we really
monster
gotta
food?
Work on your taste,
but the cage.
You get it?
We need the cage.
Taste
we go into that fortress with our monster peacefully walking beside us. We'll be laughed right out of the room.
Any bites?
Why are you whispering?
Don't pet the tentacle thing.
Gamora thinks we can sell our monster act better if we have a proper cage. Only problem is, there's a pissed off monster inside.
Release the beast, let me dispose of it.
Because that worked so well for you last time.
We need a better plan of attack.
Yes. Ideally, one that guarantees my safety as leader.
Uh-oh. Hello. Oh, good. Two of them. Okie doke. These are the ones with double health bars, right? Oh, it's the one we hurt last time. Okay. Right. High damage. Go. Okay. That's a good start. Huddle ready. Do it.
Guys, huddle up!
Hey, friends.
This battle could be over, traitor, if you would leave the bludgeoning to me.
Not my fault you're slower than my sword.
You're both slow. 50 units as me and Groot can mow them all down without you.
I am Groot.
Okay, we're pros. We've proven it hundreds of times before. This isn't a competition. Guardians win fights together.
Whoa, guys! Y'all keep saying you're better than the rest, like a dance competition where the losers failed the test. Well, those scut plugs on the field only want to take us out. So if we don't dance together, this whole fight will be a rout.
Who's with me? Wise words, Peter!
Hell yeah, we picked the right one. Let's fucking go! Nice, nice job. Got him. Oh god. Oh. Very nice.
You are coming with me.
First rain, then jelly, then slimy, stinky crawl spaces, and now all these monsters. I hate this flarking planet.
I hate everything, Rocket.
True, but especially the stinky slime tunnel part. Itchy fur is where I draw the line.
We do smell exceptionally foul.
Yeah, way worse than usual. I swear, Quill, that's the last time I follow you through rock poop.
Hey, we're a team. If we're gonna smell like butt, we're gonna smell like butt together.
That is most eloquent, Peter Quill. I will smell like butt with you.
Yeah, really great speech.
Oh, fuck, I love these characters, man. Oh, boy. Yeah, that was so much easier fucking using the left trigger, dear God. Imagine forgetting that there was a lock on.
Who's next in line with the throne if Lady Hellbender has an accident?
Perhaps she is immortal.
Nobody's immortal. Not even death herself.
I can't believe you just said that with a straight face.
Right, okay, doesn't look like there's much around here, so let's press on. There is some right here, very nice.
Groot says we should check things out over here.
Okay, there's a path for Groot to grab over there, so let's do that.
Groot, give me a bridge here. The fortress is right on the other side of those cliffs.
This is actually the best surprise of the year. Like, a game that I really wasn't expecting to love. And I just... it's amazing. Okay, so we can get through there with the ice thing. All around here. Which way is the secret way? Okay, well, there's some of this here.
So, when are the rest of us gonna get jet boots?
It takes years of special trained operating things.
You had years of jet boot lessons.
No, but the guy I took them off of did.
Who stole them?
He was dead. Flew into a ceiling fan.
Ah, very nice. Very, very nice. Who's this for? Oh my god, 5 Horsemen of the Apocalypse outfit found. That looks insane. What? What? I am Groot. Rocket addendum. Groot's been telling me about this recurring nightmare where he's frothing evil. The rest of us, too. Like, instead of guarding the galaxy, we're the ones destroying it. I can't see him ever being part of something like that. I wonder what he'd look like if he was. First appeared in Guardians of the Galaxy 8 Age of Apocalypse variant. Wow. Yeah. I mean, let's try it.
Deep freeze.
Whoa. Can I try ice cubing something?
Look at him.
Nope.
That's crazy.
Man, you're such a gas flap.
So if we're gonna haggle with the Monster Queen, how much are we asking for our monster?
395 million units, give or take two. One for every precious hair follicle on this flawless
body. You have counted them. That is bizarre.
Hey, at least I have some to count.
Give it a slice, Gamora.
Sharp ain't never heard of roads.
You'd have to clear parts of the jungle to do it, which would probably mean killing some of the wildlife.
Good. They deserve it.
Sektor 9 is a sanctuary. They say that if you leave behind a single piece of refuse, Lady Hellbender will personally return it to you. The most unpleasant way.
That can't be true.
God damn, dude. God damn.
Oh, that is definitely in my top 10 fortresses.
What the fuck?
Hi.
You said that quarantine zone monster was supposed to be rare.
She already has a whole herd of them?
Oh, good.
So, we wasted our time. Almost got killed for nothing.
And got arrested. That was fun.
It was moderately amusing.
Now we've got a ticking time bomb on the ship, and we owe money to the cops. All because of one lousy source.
Hi, Groot.
Guys, every misstep was just a step in the right direction towards completing our best plan yet.
Say that again?
What if we brought one of those ugly suckers all the way here only to find out Lady H already had a full set?
That would have sucked big time.
Exactly. If we even got that far. What if we've been towing that thing when Nova Corps intercepted us?
That would have been taken very bad.
See? This is working out. Sure, in a kind of bumpy, chaotic way, but we've still got a plan.
Well said. Oh boy, how's
that
this going to go?
Quill.
Surprisingly light.
If we put our monster in it, will he shrink as well?
No, it would compress anything inside to a mound of twitching boar.
Neat.
Don't get any ideas.
That is a little bit worrying. That is a little bit worrying when she laughs like that. Okay,
well,
fight room.
Let's just get this done.
We're almost there. What the fuck was... What? Oh, not fire room. Those are, like, guards, I guess, leaving the fortress?
You can't be serious.
Okay. It's farther than it looked. Much farther.
It's a fucking infinity bridge is what it is.
Are you being dramatic, Rodent? Bridge ends at the fortress, therefore it is not infinite.
Yeah, that's super comforting.
I like the rain effects on the character's skin and armor and shit.
Cycles.
It looks really good.
Peter?
Aren't you forgetting something?
Are you Groot?
Oh, right. Cage.
The point of even getting a Farkin thing is looking like we mean business.
All right, Rocket. Time to put on your monster face.
I only got one face, Quill.
Are you sure about this, Peter? Look at him. You better have one hell of a sales pitch.
Show off salesmanship or change your mind. So you can put Groot in instead? We should try selling Groot in instead. Let's do that. What was my reasoning again? It was because it's gonna be a lot harder. If we sell Rocket to her, it's gonna be a lot easier to like bust him out than selling Groot to her and then having to bust out a massive tree. Like you can't really hide a massive tree on your way out. But we would hopefully be easily able to smuggle Rocket out, is the thought process. So let's show off salesmanship.
Remind me again, how many missions have we been on so far?
13.
14, if you count Contraxia.
Contraxia was not a mission. It was a mistake.
All right. Point is I was able to sell you, Gamora, daughter of Thanos, intergalactic assassin, as a hero. 14 times!
Fine.
I think he's made his point.
See you soon, bud.
Drax. Gamora, can you help me with this? What? Why?
No.
To guarantee your safety as our leader.
Ooh!
Come on.
She's got you there, Quill. Now shut up and start pulling. Will you stop worrying so much? You're gonna start growing knots again.
Okay, here we go.
Onwards. What a cool looking entrance. Now, I can't go left or right with this. I can only push forward, so...
Whoa, whoa. A little bit close.
They seem so peaceful here.
Never saw a real whale when I was a kid. I guess this sort of counts.
I'm sure it's real pretty, but can we not draw its attention while I'm stuck in a flarkin cage, please?
The cage looks a little bit jerky as it goes along the bridge. But, it is quite an epic looking scene.
Does anybody have, like, a campfire song or something we can sing to kill the time? Ooh, I know one. It's called...
Please Stop.
Right, yeah. Okay. Wait, is Please Stop the name of your song?
No.
Okay. So, how long before someone else wants to pull this thing?
You're 60 clicks from the fortress.
I'd say closer to 75.
There is only one way to know for sure. 0.1 clicks. 0.2 clicks.
God damn it.
0.9. 2.1.
0.3 clicks.
4.5.
0.4 clicks. 0.5 clicks. 0.6 clicks.
For the love of Flark, stop counting clicks.
Almost there. Almost there. Come on. That animation does look really jerky for some reason. I wonder why.
We could take turns extolling the virtues of the monster queen.
Quietly.
Hey, birthday boy. Whether you can hear me.
Meredith? Is that Mum?
Star-Lord. Who's the guy with the scary eyes?
Oh, this is from the start, right?
If you don't hurry, I'm gonna eat that whole cake myself.
Are we gonna have a flashback?
In whole years.
Yep.
Look at you. Where does time go?
I'll be up in a sec, I promise.
Right.
Okay. Well, we've already looked around the whole room, right? So what, we couldn't go out here before, this is new.
Mom says Grandpa used to play this a lot when she was a kid, but it's been busted ever since I can remember.
Sad times. I used to play the piano.
I'm enough to spend the night in the yard soon. I love falling asleep looking at the stars, wondering what might be out there.
There's a whole lot out there, man. The fridge is open even in the fucking past. Why is the fridge always open? We'll make a stand.
Don't give a damn. Hank says you can get a brain parasite if you share a toothbrush. Imagine that. Something growing inside of you, slowly taking over.
Yeah. That's funny. I can't believe they had the fridge open in the past also. Just like the game's running gag.
If push comes to show. Oh man, this is so cool.
Bring hell down from above. Nice. Anything over here? Into the fire. Are you ready to go, go, go? Nope, okay, let's head up. Beware of Raccoon.
Well, 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 look who decided to finally come up.
Where's my cake?
I warned you.
I didn't.
I am so...
That's good banter. That is great banter.
Okay, sit your butt down, Slowpoke.
It's a little Pac-Man cake. Oh, that's cool.
Don't worry, I'm not gonna sing.
That's very cool.
Well, you might be the only one.
And Pac-Man styled happy birthday banners.
Oh, somebody's got a girlfriend. Is it Janie? Oh, yes.
It's not Janie.
She is so smart. Love Janie. Okay, I'm just teasing. What did you wish for?
Why would I wish for anything? I've got everything I want.
Aww.
Oh, what huge favor are you about to ask me?
Just $10. Dan, Andy, and I want to go see Night of the Cosmos at the Rio tonight.
A movie. Tonight.
Come on. It's going to be sick.
Oh, she made plans for us?
It's zombies that invade Earth, and then it's up to these kids that have to blow them away.
I don't think I want you to see that, Peter. I let you watch the hockey mask one, and you were sleeping in my bed the next 3 nights.
Deflect. Didn't you see worse movies at my age or qualify? This one's not so bad. That deflect doesn't really work. It's the old do as I say, not as I do kind of thing.
That was ages ago. And this one isn't even that bad. It's PG-13. And I'm 13.
Exactly. PG-13 may contain violence and nudity.
Mild nudity, like butts and stuff.
You ain't getting full frontal in PG-13.
No, I just, I wanted us to have some us time tonight, you know? Maybe finish our game. You can't duck out right when I'm about to win.
I wonder why. I wonder what she, is there something bad happening tonight that she wants to protect us from? Or is there something that she's already got planned for us? I feel like it's not just that she wants to spend time with us. It sounded like, the way she was talking, it sounded like there was something more to it. It's my birthday. We can still do all that stuff. That sounds kind of bratty, so.
We can still do all that stuff. Or some of it. Tomorrow. You're always telling me to get out of the house more.
A movie theater does not count as out of the house, and you know it.
Doesn't it?
Pretty please?
I don't know. Truck's still in the shop, and I don't want you walking alone in the dark. There's been a lot of weirdos out there. It's not safe.
Reassure. I'll be careful. Argue. Let's reassure.
I'll be careful, Ma. I always am.
Were you careful when you got that black eye?
I told you,
I was... I know! You were standing up for someone, which is a good thing. But you cannot go punching your way out of every problem, Peter.
I couldn't just stand there.
No.
I'm guessing this is the night he gets taken.
Okay, get me my purse. Not so fast. Before you go, there's something I want to talk to you about, something I want to give you.
$20?
Don't push it. Think of it as a long overdue gift from your father. It's upstairs on my bed. Go on and get it while I finish up in the kitchen. And we can open it together.
Is this something he said give him when he turns 13 or something? Interesting, interesting. Okay, let's have a look around.
Leave that alone. I love it. And look, it even has your little handprint on it.
Aww. Pretty sure I made a cup back in school.
The cake looks super professional. You sure you didn't buy it?
Save the flattery, Peter.
I mean, it does look really good. I'd fucking eat the shit out of that.
Boring.
Soup and salad. Truly the best book. Hey, this fridge isn't open. It's a miracle. Can we read anything on there? Not really. Nice pick.
I want you home right after the movie.
Can't we stop by the arcade for a bit?
Keep pushing your luck, mister, and you won't be going anywhere. Don't you dare touch that dial.
Yes, Mom.
I left the gift on my bed.
Oh, I thought you said outside.
Maybe I'll go get it, and you can finish up here instead.
No, that's okay.
Then get a move on.
Why does that light flicker when I move? Like, that light is perfectly fine now, and then I move, Wait, it's not doing it now. Oh, it's when I move. Is it when I move the camera? Whatever.
Shoot. Mom told me to put the laundry away 2 days ago. I'll do it first thing in the morning.
That's,
Scout's honor.
Yeah, there's a little bit of a delay on that. I can't believe she's left it there that long. If my dad told me to do something, and it was something that was, like, in a communal area, like, right next to this kitchen and, like, dining area and stuff, and it was just sat there, there's no way he'd let it slide for 2 days that I hadn't got it done. If it was, like, something in my room, then that he wasn't, like, constantly seeing, then he'd probably let it slide, but not in an area like that.
Hansel stings from catching Mom's fastball. Wonder if she got me a new glove for my birthday. Gotta remember to give this to Andy later. You know, he was a pretty good sport about not putting the Star-Lord patch on his jacket, too. We'd have looked like complete dorks if we both had it.
I am the one true Star-Lord.
My pants didn't do much better than my eye in that fight.
Aww. It's nice that he was sticking up for people even when he was younger. Star-Lord is like...
You know, I was talking to Janie's mom the other day.
Here we go. She's a lovely girl, Peter. She listens to disco, Mom.
Star-Lord is like... Bit of a dork. Very nerdy. This version of him when he's grown up is like... Kind of a... Surfer dude kind of thing going on. But he's always got that like good heart. He's always wanting to help people who need helping.
Will Dan and Andy be spending the night? You can all help me with the yard work in the morning.
I knew there had to be a catch.
Woofa!
Hey Kubrick, buddy. No matter how long you wait here for Grandma and Grandpa, they're not coming back. Sorry.
Aww. That's sad. Grandma and Grandpa have died? Is that the implication? And he's waiting for them? I'll give him the good pets.
So what? Now you're too old for gifts?
What? No. I was just looking around. Remembering things.
Grandma and Grandpa. Wish they could have been here too.
More pets! Oh, what a good boy. Oh, you have that good stretch, my dude. You have that long stretch. Oh, I love him. I love doggos.
How are you getting to the movie?
Andy said his older brother would give us a ride.
Make sure he brings you back, too.
Oh, crap. I'm gonna miss Knight Rider. Guess I'll just have to wait for the rerun.
Man, Knight Rider was great back in the day. Knight Rider was the shit. With Kit. Oh man, what a great show. Maybe it would seem shit now, I don't know, I haven't watched it in a long, 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 long time, but when I was young, that show was awesome.
Mom's pretty close to winning this game.
That looks like a pretty cool game. I want to get into board games one day. I've never really had the opportunity to play like any big board games. Like obviously there's the regular little board games you play as a kid, like, you know, Mousetrap and the Game of Life and that kind of shit, but like the big, like, in quotes, grown-up board games, shit like, I don't know, what's a big one, Gloomhaven, stuff like that. I would like to get into those at some point, but gotta have a group of people near you that also are interested in that, which I don't.
Little guy put up a big fight. Wouldn't have been able to land him without Grandpa's tricks.
But hopefully one day.
Wake me up before you go-go. Don't leave me hanging on like a yo-yo.
Okay, that's a... that mirror is not working great. What on earth? What is going... Hello? We're in a simulation. Nothing's real. Wake up, Peter!
Do 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 do.
Oh, Grandma and Grandpa.
So Grandma used to take me into town on Sundays to run errands. We'd stop for ice cream on the way home. Even in winter.
Man. I miss my grandma, grandpa.
Man, am I glad I finally got my hair the way I like it.
That's the way you like it, huh? Curious.
Sometimes grandma and grandpa would let me sleep with them if I was too afraid down in the basement.
Wait, where was this thing? I've already forgotten where I'm supposed to be looking. Wasn't it around here somewhere? I thought she said in her room. Maybe this is just to get... Oh, actually, right, because he just said grandma, that's their old room. Got it.
I don't know much about art, but I know that this is excellent. Grandma really had talent. Gonna have to get Mom to show me how to shoot. Grandpa was supposed to this summer.
Aww.
Meredith Quill. Perfect game. Not bad.
Well in, Mom.
Dance's every UFO sighting is really a weather balloon or a bright star. But there's so many of them. Couldn't a few be real?
Hardcore UFOs. That's hardcore, bro.
Sure, it'd be nice to believe there are other worlds out there, but what are the odds? Pretty slim, I bet.
Yeah.
Sky's clear. Wonder if Mom will spend the night stargazing since I'm heading to the movie.
Whoa, what was that camera? Yeah, tonight's definitely going to be the night it gets taken, right? And we're going to see it in flashbacks. Maybe not now. At the start, I thought it was just going to be the opening to the game that was a flashback. But now that it's happened again, I imagine it'll probably happen multiple times throughout the game. And we'll progress through and see him be taken and see his first steps into his new life kind of thing.
I know it sounds crazy, but Mom's convinced my dad was an alien. She really believes it. Could she be right?
Oh, interesting. There's not been any mention of that until now. Like, we knew that Dad wasn't around, but I don't think they've ever actually specified what he was or the fact that Peter knows about it. I'm not sure why she would tell him that. Like, he's only just turned 13. I feel like you're just going to get ridiculed if you tell your kid, yeah, by the way, I think your dad was an alien. He's not around anymore, but... Is it going to be the guns? I mean, I'm not sure why you'd give a 13-year-old the guns. Okay, that's where the thing ends. Cool.
Huh? We have arrived at the Monster Queen's fortress.
Oh.
At its entrance, anyway.
Chapter 4, The Monster Queen.
So, as I was saying, I can handle a little solo extraction.
No offense, but you ain't exactly invested in my safe return. My skin, my plan.
Your call, Peter.
It is. I'm the one
side with Rocket.
Peter Quill is our leader. The burden of your possible death falls on his shoulders.
Fully on board with Rocket's plan that I was totally paying attention to.
See? Even Captain Space Cadet don't trust your gymnastics.
Wait, what about gymnastics?
I just think we shouldn't be relying on a piece of tech you won't even be around to use.
It ain't neutrino splicing. It's a tracker. Even you mouth breathers can figure it out.
A tracker on you so we can steal you back. Great idea, Rocket. Let's do this.
Yeah, I mean, that does sound like a good idea. Well, we are just at the entrance. Oh, man, look at that. I can't actually turn... I can't turn it any further.
Casino Cosmico in here. Just be glad we didn't cram your branches in this box.
So this is like the basin thing, the bowl that the fortress is in. But it looks like it's a whole biome unto itself. That's pretty cool. Alright, let's head in.